So first of all, we had to correct one mistake last time. We wanted to show that it's possible to build this QR decomposition without automatics. And I will do it by example. The mistake was that I was going from the left, from the beginning to the end, and I have to go from the right. So I will make one example will be more clear. Let us say that I have one matrix, 1, 0, 1, 1, 2. Then I have 1, minus 1, 1, 1, 0, 1. Then I have 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay? And I want to multiply this by, so this is 5 by 3, okay? I want to multiply by h1, h2, H3, and I want to obtain something like A, B, C, zero, 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 zero. And this should be 5 by 5. Because this should be 5 by 5. I will compute H1. Then after computing H1, I will show that I can compute H2 just the same. Okay? So I want H1, what I want here. I could even have I want H1 I can do like this. I can add 1 0 0 1 0 0 and 1 householder matrix. This is 3 by 3. How I will build this householder matrix? Okay. H times 0 0 1 will be 1 0. Okay. Let us see if it works. It works. Okay. So metrics are immeasurable. These are isomers. This was A. So what I will get? When I multiply by B, I will get h prime times this in the last column of the product, you have to make rows of h prime times the last column of this. And since we suppose that this will be 1 0 0, here you get 1 0 0. Okay? But what you know more? You know that this, for example, this where it depends, because isometry, this fully is an isometry, so does not change the fact that these three columns were should be independent. Yes. Because this one only here, and then these two are in. Okay, but after that, now I have one matrix like this. Let us say that this is this matrix I call V. Now I want H2. How? H2. H2, I want like this, 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0, and H2 prime. I want that will be so what I so first of all this row it just stays the same in the first row when I make the problem, and when I compute the when I compute H2B, this first row stays the same, and from second row this I can here I have something that is the same as before. Here I have H2 prime B prime. where B prime is this. Thank you. 1006. So this is x, and this is y. So the difference is 2. So I have 1 minus a, b, c, and the difference, it should be lambda, so a minus 1, b, c, okay. And this has to be orthogonal to w, has to be orthogonal to this. So we have to have this condition: x plus this is equal to 0. So let us okay. I can put some. Just here the number, let us say that I don't want 1. Let us say that I want some other letter, constant mu. Now I can adjust. Why? This is a number. I just can, this is A, B, X, and 1 are just numbers, and I can compute mu. Okay? So, what does it mean? It means that I can send this to this. I can send this to this. Okay? But since this vector is in the orthogonal to that vector, to w, because this is proportional to W, the vector used to be the outside matrix. Huh? This minus this, it is 2 lambda W, and so this is the vector I will use to compute the outside matrix. So after multiplication was this, we go to this, but I know that what is orthogonal, it is not touched by this multiplication. So, if I adjust mu in such a way that this is orthogonal, this vector is orthogonal to this vector, to the vector x1, c, here, and then I can obtain. This is the idea. Then I won't go into the details, but. Then I can have some letter here and some zeros here, and I can go. Okay. By induction, I will. So the main was not that I have not to start from the first rule, but to start from the last. This was. Then proof can be worked out. Okay. Then. In any case, we already knew. I don't want to work out examples because otherwise we will lose 1 hour, more than 1 hour, just to work out the example. We knew that this decomposition could be made with it via Gram-Schmidt method. But it can be done also with this method, and the key is not to go from first vector to last vector, but to go in the other direction. Then, now we have one more important topic, and this topic is, we have two matrices. A is Cn by n, and B is Cn by n. What do we want to do? We want to compute. So these are square matrices. We can compute eigenvalues. And in some better than this, m by n, n by n. So I can compute both. I can compute both a, b. This is c n by n, and I can compute b a. That is c n by n. Okay. So what I want to do now, I want to compute the eigenvalues of both matrices, to compare. And in some way, these eigenvalues are the same. This is obviously not true. Why? This could be 3 by 3, for example, and this could be 7 by 7. So this can have different number of eigenvalues. But you have to remember that the rank of AB is equal to the rank of BA. The rank is the same. And this is obvious because when you compute square matrices of the product, you have to compute square submatrices of matrices of the product. You have to compute square submatrices of A times a square submatrices of B, and the determinant of the product is different from zero if and only if. Actually not, but they are, the rank is the same. Sorry, it's not the same. I can provide the same. I can have 1, 1, 1 minus 1. Okay? If I multiply, the rank is 1. But in any case, both, if I multiply, I have 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, okay, that is 1. If I multiply in the other direction, this is 0. And if 1 by 1, this is 2 by 2, and that is 0, and here that is 1. But I got mistaken, but this is less than or equal to the minimum between the rank of A and the rank of B. And both is true, the same is true for the other multiplication. This is still. So this is for sure less than or equal to the minimum between M and N. Okay.
What do I want to say? I want to say that, let us say that N is bigger than N. What I want to say is that in both cases, at the minimum, n minus n eigenvalues of the biggest n should be zero. This you know for sure. Okay. So let us say that we have. V such that V of V is equal to lambda V. We know that AB of B is equal to lambda B. Send this V in sum lambda to the minus 1/2. Lambda is complex number. What is this number? This number is the reciprocal of one of the two square root of lambda. Lambda is different from zero. In complex numbers, you have two square roots. You take one and take the reciprocal. Times d v, and we call this w. Okay? Now, let us compute a w. us say that I compute now BRW. What is this? This is lambda 1 half degree. I just multiply by so this is lambda times W. So sorry, I assume that lambda is different from zero. I assume that lambda is different from zero. I assume this. Okay? Probably I made some mistakes somewhere, but now I'm correct. So what does this argument prove? This argument proves that if V is eigenvector for AB with eigenvalue correspondent eigenvalue lambda different from zero. This implies that lambda to minus 1 half dv is eigenvector for vr with the same eigenvector lambda. So should be that AB and this argument is symmetric. So if we that eigenvalue is different from zero for AB and BA should be the same. Now let me, because if I, and now we have to check this with this example, because in this example, this take this 2x2 matrix. This 2x2 matrix is 1 minus 1, 1, so this this matrix, this is AB. You remember that A was 1, 1 and B was 1, the opposite. This is 1, 1 followed and this is 1, minus 1. So when we compute the characteristic polynomial of AB, lambda minus 1 times lambda plus 1 is lambda squared minus 1 plus 1, it is lambda squared.
Yes.
No, it's correct. Everything is correct. Why? Because you have two eigenvalues, but it's not possible. Yes, no, it's possible. You have one eigenvalue here. You have only eigenvalue zero. You have no if you have all eigenvalues zero, matrix should not be zero. It's not. If you have, let us say, you have one matrix with 0, 1, 0, 0. All eigenvalues are zero, but the matrix is not zero. Because the eigenvalues are both zero. But the eigenspace of the null eigenvalue is not C2, is one method. Okay? And so you see, and you could tell by this, when you multiply here, this was 0, this 1 by 1 method, as the only element is 0, it's one number, this is the other number. Okay? Since here there are not IMLs different, there are not. AB by this result is correct. Cannot have it. Only I can have only a value zero. Okay? Okay. So what does this result prove? This result proves that of course, this is phi of B. What is phi to the minus 1? Phi to the minus 1 of W is lambda to the minus 1 half times A times W. This is the inverse. This is linear application from Cn to Cn. And this is the inverse. Why? Because if I multiply, if I apply this, I take lambda minus 1 half 2 times is lambda 2 minus 1. Then I have ABV, but ABV is lambda V over lambda, it cancels. At least from where, which is the domain? The domain is the eigenspace lambda of AB to the eigenspace lambda of the matrix B. Here is the phi, and this is phi to the minus 1. If you apply phi, you go from the eigenspace, you take V. V is in the eigenspace E lambda AB, and W is in the eigenspace E lambda of BA. We prove this. But this is true if lambda is different from zero.
corresponding eigenspaces are isomorphic. Okay?
Space, of course, if you remember, it has a dimension 2, but starting from here, what we want to do now? We want, now we have A, AC, M times N matrix. These are positive numbers, such that S1, for example, is greater than S2, is greater than S3, is greater than Sk, and then is strictly greater than zero, and then are positive. After the
plan. But I will want to see which are the what are these numbers? Where they come from? Because they are
they are definitely not even if A was square, they are not the eigenvalues of E. They are not. Why? Because A, for example, can have only complex eigenvalues. And so eigenvalues for sure are not numbers in this case, because I want positive numbers. Okay?
But let us say, let us compute A, let us assume that we already proved such kind of evolution. Okay? And let us compute AHA and AAH. So what do we know? AHA is VSH UH U S the H. Okay? In the other way, we have U S the H V S H U H. So what is this? This cancels because these are unit elements. So this is amounts to V S H S V H. And this amount to is cancelled just the same. And we have U S S H U H. And so these are just about rotation.
Rotation either rotation plus one, change of sign.
And what are these? So these two matrices, they have, remember that these two matrices, these are, it's true that they have the same rank, we prove. AB and BA in general not, but AAH and AHA, they have the same rank, we prove. Then, what are these? They are, if you remember, they are self-adjoint matrices. And so, since they are self-adjoint matrices, remember also that this is the inverse of this. So when you compute the eigenvalues of this matrix, the eigenvalues of this matrix are the eigenvalues of this matrix. And the eigenvalues of this matrix are the eigenvalues of this matrix. Because this is V, V minus 1, U, U minus 1. So what, when you multiply by matrix and inverse left and right, the eigenvalues didn't change. We proved this. So they both have the same eigenvalues different from zero. Because A, B, E. There are a certain number of eigenvalues different from zero. And which are these eigenvalues? Since S was S, S, H, I can even write like this because S is diagonal. S, H, so S, A, S. So, sorry. No, I cannot write like this.
find put in a way that they are decreasing. And then you have the zero. Okay? So this decomposition we still have to prove. This is called singular various decomposition. And what are these singular values? S1, Sk. That's the square root of the eigenvalues of this domain. Of the positive eigenvalues of this domain. And then you have to just to finish with something. How many zeros? It depends. You have k number different from zeros, and then you have to have m by m matrix, either n by n, and then you have to put m minus k or either n minus k zeros. Okay? Is that clear? So, I will say just one more time. And then we will have 5 minutes left. So what did we prove? We proved that between the eigenspaces, I take two matrices, I just walk the number of columns and the number of rows in such a way that AB and BA are both square. For example, one matrix is 3 by 5 and the other matrix is 5 by 8. Then I take one of these two products and I assume that I have some eigenvalue different from 0 if it is decreased. We may even get one example that it can not exist in some case. In this case there was no eigenvalue. But if it exists one eigenvalue different from zero, you take the corresponding eigenspace and you have application. This application invertible, so isomorphism between the eigenspace of the with respect to the eigenvalue lambda, so the matrix AP, and to the eigenspace with the same eigenvalue lambda with respect to the matrix BA. Since this argument is semantic, you just prove that when you have some eigenvalue for one of these two products, AB or BA, different from zero, you have the same eigenvalue for the other product the other way around, and the correspondent eigenspaces have the same dimension and the rest. Okay? Okay. But then we now take any matrix Cn m by n and we want to obtain a decomposition like this A equal to U S B H, where U and B are different but they are constrained matrices, they are just unitary matrices, just rotation matrices besides the fact that they can have
the remnant is equal to one complex number of models.
Okay. And isometric matrix, unitary matrix. Okay. So you have, and so what this does this mean? This means that if you A is an application, well, usually you have such things. You have A, U, X. This is in, or take, let us call V in C and N. You have A, V in C, N. Then you have, you fix a base B in C,
And then you have correspondent as well. Okay, so, sorry. You have A P of B X A X and C M and you fix another phase here. You have phi A, this is in V, and this is in W. So, dimension of V is N, dimension of W is N. You have this diagram. This is called commutative diagram, because you can do like such this, such or this. You can do like this or this, and in any case, you will have just the same. You cannot do like this in general. You have to follow arrows. But these arrows, these are in both sides. Because fixed the base in CN, one vector the other coordinates and vice versa. So you have two. Complex vector space, and this is of dimension n, and this of dimension n. And when you have coordinates vectors in Cn, you multiply by a and you get vector in Cn. And here corresponded the linear application phi A, the one that makes this diagram commutative. Okay, this is just trivial generation. But then you can change base. Here, how we want to change base. So we want to change base in the sense that here we have B prime, so you have X prime, and we want that here we have BH. Then here, we can change base, another base, B prime CN, so these are completely different. This is not the same base, because we are in different spaces. Okay. This is the reason I put CN here, CN here. Not remember that we are not changing the same. But what we want, when I change base, I have that this corresponds to multiplication by a linear matrix in matrix. But if I just make a change base that is isometric, I can have that here I get some matrix U. And there I get the matrix DH. And here we have wave time. So this is Y. So we have U1. So when we go to track this map, we get U, where is AX, but X is BH. Here we want B, and here we want UH. Okay?
but just by using this method, I am assuming already that I proved this decomposition, singular verb decomposition. Now, if this is true, let us substitute the decomposition of A here. So you get UH, U as the H, B. So this cancels with S. So what is the interpretation of the singular value decomposition? The singular value decomposition says that you take the matrix A, once you get this decomposition, you have that the matrix A corresponds to linear application phi A from Cn to Cn. But if in the domain you make a suitable rotation that corresponds to multiply by B, and corresponds to multiply the new coordinates to get the old coordinates by B. So if you want the new coordinates, you have to multiply this by B to the minus 1, that is the H. And here, you want that the new coordinates will be the old coordinates multiplied by UH, because here you go in. And these are, there is, the notations are sound because you go always in the same, since you go from old coordinates to new coordinates and vice versa. Here you are, if you put V here, you have to put UH here. You can even put U here and VH here, but then the composition should be UH as V. Otherwise, you will not. But if you with that decomposition, this is arbitrary. If you put the H here or there, it's just notation. But if you put U here you want the matrix UH. And if you put VH there, here you want matrix B. And if you get these two rotations in the domain and in the codomain in the image space, then how it is VA of X prime, what is S? X prime. If you use these two bases, if you change base in a certain way, you get the what was the linear application corresponding to the matrix A now is the linear application corresponding just to this situation. You multiply the first k vectors of the new base for Sj. So the first vector is eigenvector with eigenvector S1. The second vector is eigenvector with eigenvector S2. The k vector of the new base is eigenvector with eigenvector Sk. And then all other vectors in this base are the eigenvectors for the loop. Object that, but not, it's not possible. Why? It's not possible because when I multiply by the ILS, it should not change. No, can change. Why? First of all, the matrix A, so not the eigenvectors, sorry. These are not eigenvalues and eigenvectors because phi does not go from the same. Does not go, this goes from Cn to Cn to Cn to Cn to Cn, n and m are different. So, but, phi of E1 in Cn is S1 E1 in Cn. Understand? even if A is square, if A is square matrix, you this multiplication they change the eigenvalues of A. Why? Because they didn't change only when you used some matrix on the left and the inverse matrix on the right. But here you use different matrices. U, H and B. Understand? You change in a different way in the domain and the image space. But if you change this in a proper way, you are still constrained to change, because this is not just general matrices, it's just metrical matrices. These are unitary matrices in the domain and in the image space. So, when you do like this, what do you get? If you do it in this suitable way, you will get, let us pretend that the beginning A equals square, then you will get the eigenvalues will be S1, S2, S3. So, that are not the original eigenvalues of A, but are the square roots of the eigenvalues of A, AH, and AHA. Okay? Okay.